with our friends to have an afternoon to remember in terms of the music. So the very first thing we'd like you to do is to stand for the National Anthems, which were performed by Trevor Hassan, MBE, and by Jolene Mabry.
Tell me. was Deputy Lieutenant, High Sheriff, U.S. Consulate Foreign Service Officer Paul Rowell, distinguished guests, colleagues and friends, and very specially, our very special, amazing guests from Clover and Clover High School Marching Band. Well. Honestly, I don't think I have saw or experienced or felt anything so awesome. I'm actually really pleased with myself to get in to speak here because I was nearly crying when I was watching you all. It was so emotional and so amazing. But in the three great linguistic traditions of our community, I want to say welcome, Cairo my Fulcher, and Fair Fayye. What a great pleasure today to see everyone here and to have enjoyed the amazing spectacle of Clover High School Marching Band come through our town. We have marching bands in Larne, but absolutely nothing on this scale. It is truly awesome, and this will be a day to remember and cherish for a long, long time in Larne. The Larne Twinning with Clover originated in 1996 with the local council unanimously back a proposal to link up with your wonderful community. In 2002, this was extended to a link with your county. Apologies. With your county, generally a very active Ulster-American committee assisted Larne Borough Council to make this a very strong link. It followed the erection a few years earlier of the Ulster American Memorial at Curran Park, where there was a beautiful service there earlier. The memorial remains a focal point of our remembrance of the strong ties which bind Northern Ireland and the United States. How fitting it was that your parade started from that park today. From the pioneers and frontier men and women, to the White House and even to the moon, the descendants of Ulster settlers have blazed a trail in the United States. As Mayor of Mid and East Antrim Borough, I would like to say how incredibly pleased we are that today you have blazed a trail to our area. Your visit has been all too short and we hope you will return. I would like to thank Dr. Stephen Reid of Larne High School for hosting the band earlier today, and Ben Harvey of Alderfleet Primary, and Kirk Patterson of Larne and Inver Primary for hosting teachers in their school this afternoon. I would like to thank all our entertainers, musicians and dancers, and I would like to say a big thanks to those who have come out today to support the event. The bagpipe was fantastic, Trevor, and also Zolene, your singing of the American National Anthem was absolutely breathtaking. Thanks to Celtic Horizon Tours for their support and getting everyone to Larne to spend this wonderful afternoon with us. Here we go again. It has been a privilege in the past to visit Clover, and it is my privilege today to give you the warmest welcomes of Larne to Larne and to Mid and East Antrim. And when I say warmest, I have to say that our prayers were answered, because it's not really very often the sun shines, but it certainly shone today and it was incredible. It made it all the more amazing. So the sun special come out for you all from Clover today. That's a big thing. Thank you so, so much for coming to Larne.
High Sheriff, Madam Mayor, U.S. Consulate Representative, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, what a spectacle we have witnessed this afternoon already here in Larne. It is not every day that a marching band from the United States of America visits our shores. On behalf of His Majesty King Charles's Lord Lieutenant, I am delighted as one of the Deputy Lieutenants formally welcome Clover High School Marching Band and guests to County Antrim. Just to explain very briefly for our visitors the role of the Lieutenancy. Each county in the United Kingdom has someone who acts as His Majesty the King's personal representative in the area. So whenever a member of the royal family visits County Antrim, or indeed other distinguished guests, such as yourselves here this afternoon, it is the role of the Lord Lieutenant or one of his deputies, such as myself, to provide a formal welcome. As well as having a personal representative in each county, the King also has a judicial representative, and that role is undertaken by the head sheriff. For this year, that honour falls to my wife, Patricia. The High Sheriff is the oldest office under the Crown, and here in County Antrim, we are proud to say that there has been a High Sheriff since the year 1343. So for Patricia and myself, as the two representatives of His Majesty the King this afternoon, we are delighted to welcome all of our guests to Larne. We congratulate your council, Madam Mayor, for initiating this unique visit. Our thanks to Dr. David Hume and his colleagues for making all of the preparations. Of course, as the Mayor has said, there is a long and distinguished association between Clover and Larne. And indeed, as has been said, the history of our two nations is inextricably linked, and the bonds which unite us have gone from strength to strength. So as a people, we celebrate the close association this afternoon between Northern Ireland and the United States of America. It is therefore very appropriate that we have just had the opportunity to recognize the fact that many citizens from your country gave of their lives during the Second World War. The presence of a representative from the US Consulate at today's event is further evidence of the strong connections between our two nations. We are delighted to have you with us, Paul, this afternoon. Thank you to all of our guests for visiting Larne today. You are providing a wonderful spectacle for our citizens. You are exemplary ambassadors for your town, for your county, for your state, and for your nation. We are delighted that you have come to Ireland at a time when we are particularly celebrating our patron saint. Patrick tended his sheep on Slemish Mountain, just about 12 or 15 miles from where we are today. And I know that you will be en route to Dublin, where you will be participating in the St. Patrick's Day Parade. Congratulations on being chosen to take part on this unique occasion. It is an honour and a testimony to your reputation that you have been given this incredible opportunity. We hope that during your time on the Emerald Isle, you will make many happy memories and build many new friendships. And it is our hope that during your stay, you will have the opportunity to touch the spirit and feel the welcome in this very unique part of the world. It is our privilege to have you as our guests, and we look forward to hearing of your continued success. Thank you, and safe travels for your onward journey later today.
Thank you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, the Clover Marching Band. It's an honor to be here representing the U.S. Consulate with all of you today. I was first introduced to the Sister Cities program about 20 years ago and was able to participate when I was living in Asheville, North Carolina. I'm a big fan of the program. When I heard about the opportunity to speak with a group from South Carolina in this beautiful city of Larne, I jumped at the opportunity. I've not lived in Northern Ireland for a long time. In fact, I only arrived last summer. I'm constantly amazed at the impact that this corner of Ireland has made on the culture, traditions, and values of the United States. It's a small island, but the contribution your forefathers made to the traditions and values of the U.S. is profound. I was fortunate to be here several months ago for the unveiling of a blue plaque. During that trip, I learned that the Port of Larne was a particularly important departure point in the formative chapter of our shared history. As many of you may know, between 1783 and 1812, about 100,000 people had immigrated from this area to the United States. As early as 1791, between 3,000 and 4,000 people had arrived on immigrant ships in my home state of Pennsylvania. For them, the hardest part of the journey was still ahead. From Pennsylvania, the journey south towards the lands of Virginia and the Carolinas began. Over time, this route became known as the Great Pennsylvania Wagon Road. It was a challenging ordeal. Settlers were following the paths over which Native American Indians had hunted and traded. Yet the farmers, blacksmiths, and craftsmen who poured into America and cut through the vast forests were up for the task. One historian described it like this: it took a different kind of settler, someone who had cut his ties altogether, someone who didn't really have all that much to lose, to look at a wilderness and there see something more than raw materials ready for exploitation. They didn't see wolves and Indians, they saw opportunities. These rugged, determined men and women rose to every challenge they faced. Many became generals, writers, academics, and there are several U.S. presidents that have ancestral ties to this beautiful land. If we then fast forward to the 20th century, we find that the ties bonding in the U.S. with Northern Ireland were strengthened even further. During World War II, over 300,000 American troops came through the province en route to the fight. The history of America cannot fully be explained without understanding the contributions made by the people from this region. I'm not trying to compare myself to these great men and women that made these incredible sacrifices, but I now feel like I have a connection to both the Carolinas and Northern Ireland. Most of my military career is actually spent in the Carolinas. I would often have to drive down to South Carolina to the Air Force Base, and I love those trips because the whole area and state is so beautiful, and Southern hospitality is second to none. After the military, I joined the Foreign Service, and me and my family could not be happier to be selected for this posting in Northern Ireland, which we have also found to be extremely welcoming and a great place to live. I want to thank you all again for the opportunity to be with you here today. It is a real honor. I want to welcome the Clover Band, and I hope you thoroughly enjoy your time here in this beautiful part of the world. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Paul, and thank you, everyone. We will have a word from the band, but our time is very, very limited just because of the bus times that we have to adhere to. So we will have a performance from the band, but we have our Irish dancers as well, which we would like to show their skills in this area in front of us here just before the band perform. So Lisa and the Irish dancers. The dancers show of Irish dance. And before that, we have the Larne School of Irish dance. Thank you. The skill of our son. I think that the dance instructor is fantastic. Thank you very much. We have the musical director of the Clover High School Marching Band, Rick Langdale. Rick is going to have a word with us, and then our mayor is also going to have a little presentation to the band to take back to Clover with them. So please welcome Rick Langdale.
I echo the sentiments of the mayor. I have caught myself several times getting quite weepy, and I wasn't expecting that. So it's been amazing. We do talk funny. So if you find it hard to understand me, I understand that. Get that. I will point out to some kids that are way worse than I am with an accent. But Deputy Lord Lieutenant James Perry, High Sheriff Perry, Mayor Alderman Mulvaney, representatives of the U.S. Consulate, Paul Rowell. I didn't know you were from the Carolinas as well. It's exciting. School students, people of Larne, distinguished guests, and friends. This is quite the homecoming, and it's quite impressive to be able to spend this time with you. And I know you could be doing so many other things than watching a spectacle of high school students from South Carolina parade down the street. So thank you so much. I am the director of band. My name is Ricky Langdale. I am the director of bands at Clover High School. I don't teach all these people by myself. I have a wonderful team of educators that work with me and our feeder schools, and a fantastic support system of colleagues and teachers. So please don't think that I'm talented. I'm just really good at answering emails, and sometimes, actually, not always. I teach at Clover High School. One of the most exciting things about I get to experience as an educator is in my position is hearing an invitation to perform for one of our ensembles and being able to help plan that. When we learned of the tremendous honor of being selected to perform in the St. Patrick's Day Festival in Dublin, I quickly reached out to our dear friend and fellow Clover citizen, Dr. David Hume, to help us coordinate our site visit, a plan, and the necessary logistics. From the moment I met him, and we connected through our visit this past March, and we stood on this pitch and planned so many different parts of this to our return today, it has been absolutely fantastic. We have felt extremely welcomed by you all, and I can't imagine a better event as a teacher and as a citizen and as family, being able to provide for our students. So thank you so much to David. I do want to introduce someone to you, but I did want to mention, because I know we're running out of time, but I really appreciate the tremendous support from our support network, our parents. We have been treated not so much as a school group by the people here and the school officials here, but so much more like family. And that's something, and that's a testament to here to the community, testament to you and the families that you have here. So thank you for that. Larne isn't a stop on our tour. It's a visit with family, and that's so important to us at Clover High School, the town of Clover, and I'm really appreciative of that. Like all good organizations, you don't travel without the boss. So I do have a boss with me, and it's not my wife. She is also here. The next portion of the presentation, I'd like to introduce someone, invite her to join me on the platform. Ms. Tracy Stiff is an elected member of our Board of Trustees for the Clover School District in Clover, South Carolina. She is an avid supporter of public school system in South Carolina and a supporter of the Clover Band Program. So please help me welcome Tracy Stiff.
Thank you so much, Rick. And I am not his boss, I'm just standing in for his boss. Thank you so much for your introduction. It is an honor to be an elected school board of trustees member in our wonderful town of Clover, South Carolina. We are so very proud of our town, Clover, and very proud of our school district due to outstanding programs such as the Band of Clover that you witnessed here today. Because of the overwhelming hospitality, love, support shown to our entire band family, the school, and our town, I have a few presentations I would like to make. I have a resolution from the Clover School District signed by Superintendent Dr. Sheila Quinn. It is a proclamation recognizing the Clover High School Marching Band in Mid and East Antrim, Borough, and Larne in Hinterland, Northern Ireland. Whereas Clover School District has built upon the town of Clover's sister city relationship with Larne, Northern Ireland since 2007. Whereas Clover School District has honored this relationship with the naming of Larne Elementary School in 2009. And whereas Clover School District seeks to educate our students with world-class knowledge, world-class skills, and a global perspective. And whereas the Mid and East Antrim Borough and Larne and Hinterland, Northern Ireland, are providing our Clover High School marching band students, teachers, and chaperones with an unparalleled opportunity for cultural exchange and performance. And I would like to call the mayor and present this to you. Thank you so much. Congressman Ralph Norman in South Carolina, we would like to present you a U.S. flag as well as his poem. He wishes he could be here with us as well, but he did give us a nice send off. I also have a resolution from the town of Clover signed by the Honorable Mayor William Legg. It's a proclamation recognizing the Clover High School Marching Band and Mid and East Antrim Borough and Larne and Hinterland, Northern Ireland. Whereas in the spirit of friendship and goodwill, the town of Clover, South Carolina and Larne, Northern Ireland twinned in 1999 and in 2007 formally became sister cities. And whereas, while the activity between the communities have waned over the years for a variety of reasons, the connections that have been made continue to run deep throughout Clover and York County, South Carolina. And whereas the purposes of the twinning and sister city relationship included promoting deeper understanding between the people of Clover and Larne, supporting affiliations, and fostering strong links. And whereas the proof of the continued work to fulfill these purposes is evident in the naming of Clover buildings, schools, and voter precincts, and now the performance of the Clover High School Marching Band at Larne High School, the American Memorial Park, and Inver Park in Larne. The connections that have been made and the connections made today will continue to cultivate great work between our communities. Thank you all so much for attending all of our festivities today.
Thank you so much, Rick and Tracy, for those very kind words. I just would like to give you this here as a commemorate the visit, and this is from Midley Stanton Borough Council. So thank you so much. And again, I just to say just a couple of words to describe today, this afternoon. Again, the band were absolutely. The Clover High School marching band were absolutely awesome. And if I just say, simply magical, magnificent, awesome, fabulous, outstanding, it's certainly an afternoon that I will remember, and it will be one of my highlights in my year as mayor. But it's also a highlight, no doubt, for all of Larne and for Midland County Borough Council. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you just for making the effort and just coming here. It's been absolutely incredible. Thank you.
All right, so while the band gets ready to play, I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we're playing. So for the parade, if you heard us on the route, we actually played a tune by Jack Cash, Ring of Fire. We learned that there's a few Cash fans out there, and we figured that we would play something you might recognize. So that's something that we have in our repertoire. We're going to start off here with the Ring of Fire, and then we're going to have our percussion ensemble play a quick cadence. Then we're going to have our saxophone quartet play. David mentioned a connection, of course, so as so many others, our connection here to the troops that were here. This year commemorates 80 years of the D-Day and the American troops, of course, that were here during that time. And he also made the connection that famous performer and composer Glenn Miller came and performed for the troops during that time period. So our saxophone quartet actually arranged a version of In the Mood, one of his favorite charts, and they're going to play for us on our second tune, and then we're going to play an arrangement of the Irish Blessing, and then we're going to finish with our high school fight song. So this is our tune. I know you have a lot of things to do, so thank you so much for coming. And thank you so much for all of your warm wishes, and you're welcome. I know we'll be back. I know we'll be back. So this is fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, folks, sadly, the Clover High School Marching Band have to leave us to get back to their accommodation and their food tonight. But it's been an absolute delight to have had them in the town. I'm very proud to be an honorary citizen of Clover, so I'm really delighted that it's turned out so wonderful today. And it's amazing to see so many people in the town centre as a great came through. So we had them up at the high school earlier, and I know some pupils from high school have come down to see that, which is great. But at the high school, they had a demonstration of the largest percussion drum in the world to be carried on parade, which is a lambeg drum. So some of them tried the lambegs out, and it could be a contract in the offing, I think. You know, they're very good. But I would ask our lambeg drummers here over in the corner if they would say goodbye to the Clover High School band now as they leave us with the beat of Larne High. So we hope you will be back. It'll be nice to see you back again very soon. And thank you all so very much. This has been a precious time, it's been a wonderful time, and it's been Larne High. Thank you very much.